Okay.
They patched it.
What?
The menu screen is completely different. 10 p.m. Whoa, look at all these buttons.
Oh, everybody.
What the fuck are all these icons?
Whoa. Where's the sound? Ooh. I feel like this is different.
Yes. This is completely different. This is an enormous pet.
Oh, try clicking to use this.
No, but that's just the...
Can we read it? Did they insert flavor text?
I don't think so. Click a pin to move to that location. That's not nearly as fun.
No, the other one was way cuter.
I know.
He just hopped along the path. That was adorable.
Seems like you can't bring them up with the face buttons anymore. Did they make the interface not shit? Replay scenes, Paul Contradiction, Cheap Clues. Are there really only two? Alright, so it just turned to 10. What were we gonna do? I guess maybe we should... replay a scene.
Yeah, let's replay the...
So you avoid relationships with students, except for Emma, who you tried to date.
Oh, come on, Inspector, that was a long time ago.
And what about Kate Vine? Did you try to date her or not?
Oh, don't be so ridiculous.
The mouse.
Kate was an exceptionally clever girl. She knew
there's a mouse.
She wanted. She knew
on the screen. Move the mouse.
But Kate approached
her. I thought you meant an actual mouse.
It surprised me she was playing everyone in the group. Kate had more enemies than you'd think. She was a very, very manipulative young woman.
And you are a very, very creepy old man.
Nope.
And I don't trust a single
word. He's a straight shooter.
That you've said.
He would never let ethics get in the way of a deal. What do you think, Atlas? Maybe we should just go down the line.
I don't know. Should we talk to her friend?
This is not working.
What?
This is not working.
What's not working?
Clicking a pin to move to that location.
You can't use the...
I am clicking, and I'm
not
moving.
No, you can't use the directional buttons anymore, or just push...
Nope. I don't think that works. Nothing's working?
I really don't think it's my place, though.
Sweet.
Telltales.
I was really hoping.
Problems.
Hello, Inspector.
Pretty happy couple.
See you later.
Hello,
Inspector. Inexplicably.
How do we know those were real people and not just the ghosts of the restaurant? Alright, like none of the keyboard buttons are working anymore.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
So that's great. Wait.
What is happening?
I hate this new menu.
Oh.
It's strange. And nothing works.
Put it back. Make it go back.
Revert.
Revert to the old menu.
Like, how do you scroll through things? Also, it doesn't look like...
I guess you just got to click on them? You can't use up and down? I mean, I assume you tried.
No, it moves the actual menu.
Oh.
This new menu is terrible. What are you guys doing? You had a good thing.
Trying stuff out. People
Thank
probably
you.
Complained.
Probably be back later.
Oh.
Oh.
Game switch to keys and controller mode.
Oh, cool. Well, then
Aha.
Is it just... Sweet.
I found the drugs. I'm allowed to do this. This is just like Silent Hill 1.
Well,
is that the white Carmilla? Right, Camellia? Mysterious prescriptions made out to Rebecca. Very interesting.
Aura
Very
morph.
Interesting. Well, we finally had a use for the pub / restaurant.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Yay! Back to the old interface.
The cupboard downstairs.
AKA good
interface. Lots of unopened stuff in it.
Is that?
Prescriptions. Made out to you.
Mm.
Oh. They're just spare painkillers. The chemist always gives us too many. He's a friend of the family.
That is probably questionably ethical.
At least she's just so chill about it. She's
else.
Like, listen, it's just spare painkillers, you know. It's just this highly addictive substance that, at least in America, is ravaging suburbia.
She didn't seem to give us
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
And Staten Island, especially.
Yay!
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 Yay! Welcome back, Contradiction.
Welcome back.
The
real
to
Contradiction
Dave's heart.
Starts here. Hashtag the real Contradiction starts here. Hashtag join the conversation.
I mean, I don't even really know what you mean by Mongrel.
Well, generally the Mongrel means that you draw a random monster from the box.
No,
and
Mongrel.
The,
do you know what the medicine in the cupboard
the
in
the Mongrel's
for?
Difficulty
you
feed is.
You better ask Rebecca about that. I'm not exactly sure what's in there. She tends to keep her wares under lock and key. Do you know, our wedding night was quite a surprise.
All right, dude.
He was definitely looking
Rebecca keeps
intently
the cupboard locked.
Into your eyes when he said that.
Do we have any proof that Rebecca does not keep the cupboard locked?
We opened it?
Be back later on, if that's okay.
Well, this sucks. Try the door on the right. Anything in here now? No? Why do these chairs face the wall?
To put people in timeout.
Lisa falls off the stairs, Lisa
or
falls down the
stairs. Or maybe there's a beautiful view.
Maybe it's time to walk the woods in search of experience. To taste and to touch and to feel as much as a man can before he repents.
I mean, I would probably say Mongrel is probably less offensive than retard because Mongrel isn't so widely used, and unfortunately I don't think it's like something that people say. It's not like a thing.
Yeah.
To call people Mongrel.
I think that's one of
it's
those words
like,
you should probably just not
use
to refer
I mean,
to a human being.
Calling heritage into into question with
history.
Respect to humans is generally not a good grounds for insulting them.
Let's. Oh shit! Coming.
Oh. You're dropping everything, dude.
About to hit the S key, are Simon.
You are
about
so
to hit the S for Simon.
Dropping all this stuff.
Shit! I'm so drunk off my homebrew, man. I just wanted to pay Gradius on my Wii.
He also dropped like three other things, including maybe a key. People just dropping their keys.
Dude,
or keychains.
It does not look anything like 10 p.m.
I mean, maybe they're in Scandinavia.
Yeah.
Or maybe this village is
an English outpost in Scandinavia.
Yeah.
It's Vinland Saga.
It's that thing where it's sort of like dusk all day.
Yeah.
Which I think is
more
a
questions, please. Thank
thing.
You. Is this yours?
Yes.
That's kind of awesome.
That's
for
my keys.
That's the golden hour.
Oh, it must have come off when Nathan dropped my keys off. He was borrowing my car. I bet too trusting.
Ow,
sorry.
As well.
I couldn't restrain my excitement.
Because he's lying?
Owns a new car!
Bike? Can't drive? Yeah. Finally, the bike. Oh, I see. Yes.
Ah.
We're finally getting to use the bike. I was like, why are you so excited about the bike?
Fuck you!
It's
finally happening.
Work, yes. Yeah. Follow the car. But I can't drive the car yet, can I? I don't have my license.
Right.
I got a windfall from an insurance payout. Just figured I'd buy something sensible with it straight away instead of wasting the money.
What was the insurance pay?
What was the insurance pay?
The laptop got stolen down at Atlas.
An Atlas?
Well, they didn't break in. I think they just walked in and took it. The laptop was in a storeroom, but I think the lock was broken, to be honest.
Doesn't sound like they're taking their security very seriously.
I think it got a lot better after that.
I think I'll check it anyway.
I mean, who could have possibly stolen it? It's like in the village.
A car with the insurance, or a very cheap car. I'd have to have a talk with Ryan about his security measures.
Good deduction, Jenksy. Induction, maybe.
Oh, this is just from some IT guy in there. I don't need it.
I noticed some numbers on the back. Do you need these?
I don't know. What is it?
1905.
Oh,
keep that in mind.
Yeah, that's just...
0541. It's the pin for everything.
It's okay, I can remember it.
So, not an offshore savings account or anything?
No, it's... It's not important.
That is dark. Albino Doctor Who.
It looks like Jinxie sniffed out some tax evasion.
Okay, that's it.
I have read some Vinsa in my day.
Did you know about Simon's laptop being stolen?
Yeah, because it had all my college work on it, which I hadn't backed up or saved.
What?
Not that it mattered much, but I did buy a new one. And Simon uses it now. Whenever.
Hope he's using the incognito mode, if you know what I mean. That Simon's got sticky fingers.
This is Simon's. I bought this for him on holiday. So he lost it.
Dropped it.
I can't keep anything.
Wait, Jenks, you didn't give it back to him?
Nope. Now it's evidence.
This is part of the case now.
Have you seen this before?
Yeah, that's what Rem just said.
Nope. Sorry, never heard of him.
Yeah. It's the lag.
Alright.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Simon's stolen laptop. I guess we should go after the Atlas friends. Maybe, does this tie into the DVD? So, question. A bit late in asking. Why aren't you arresting the father and the accomplice for mugging you since he admitted to it?
Wait.
Knowing
you
think about this.
He said it was his gardener or some shit.
Yeah, the cleaner.
IT chap.
IT
lovely
chap.
Chap, in fact.
Oh, it's lovely chap.
Sweaty, though. It's like a double act, doesn't it?
It's actually two of the three adjectives I've used to describe you, but that's fine.
Have you seen this before?
No, sorry.
He actually sounded like he meant it.
Were you at Atlas when Simon's laptop was stolen?
Oh, I believe I was, yes. It was taken from the storeroom in the hallway.
Was it ever recovered?
No, we didn't catch anyone. We're quite exposed out here. Somebody just wandered along the lane, seen into the storeroom. It's not particularly secure. They could have been in and out within minutes. That's why we advise people to keep their valuables with them. You can't be too careful these days, Inspector.
He's got a point. Anyone of the 12 people that live in this village could have stolen that laptop. Right, he has some information for us.
Wait, is trash coming out?
Thank you. Probably
tonight,
be back
right?
later.
Yep. Let's see what the Elder Ryan has to say. The Elder Rand. Fuck! I go behind the house every time.
But it's so nice back there. It's just a nice lane.
Just a few more questions, if you don't mind.
What do you know about the IT man?
What do you know about Simon's laptop being stolen from Atlas?
No, I wasn't happy about it.
What did you do about it?
Ryan paid a con man to install a complicated CCTV system. Twice the price
it cost.
Seemed to do the trick, though. We haven't done that since.
Except for the one you
prepared. Yeah.
I guess that was long before.
Yeah.
No.
No.
Stop making eyes at me, old man.
Do you know who this is? Dean Hayfield, Aztec.
Sorry, never heard. We have, some...
How did you know it was IT?
Does our IT. Large guy. No mammoth.
He said with a haunted look.
Yeah, he looked at me. I was going to say the same thing. He was sort of
staring
into nothing.
I know. I love him, and I love everything he says. And I love exactly how he says it. You learn me a lot about a lot of the acting in this. It is kind of
that's
perfect.
That's a moment. Thank you.
Amazing.
Wait. What's that exclamation point that was on the screen? Maybe James knows something about the IT man.
Ask about a few more things, please. Do you know anything about this?
No. Wow, that was a big build-up for nothing.
Yeah.
Have you seen this before?
No.
Well, just kind of fucking striking out here.
Yeah. I think that's it. Sorry, Beckers. Sorry for bugging ya. I think that's all we got.
Ugh. I want to hit her with the painkillers.
I mean, that's... She defeated you. She preempted you. She would just admitted it and was like, look, you're going to tell me this isn't cool? It's pretty cool, right, Jenksy?
Yep,
right?
We got the
hookup,
cool,
Jenksy? Jenks. Are you cool? Okay, good.
Smoke some of these painkillers. Prove to me you're cool.
I mean, we've already talked about Salvia. Oh, wait, though there was no drugs on the...
Couple more questions.
I guess she's not related to the course.
It's
so.
Not. Yeah, it's in the restaurant.
Yeah. Seen this before? Not been so.
Why don't you squint about it?
I mean, did she maybe say something like, I don't do drugs?
Yeah, he fixed my laptop. Does he live locally? Think so.
Have you seen this before?
Why would they...
I wonder if they did that in just one marathon section, which is why some of them are so weird. Have you seen this before? Have you seen this before?
They definitely recorded all
like,
these things
great.
At one time.
Yeah.
Acknowledge my presence. Please prove to me I'm not a ghost. Have you seen me before?
Am I even real?
Alright, well, Simon, maybe there's gotta be something tying off. No, Simon said something about the stolen laptop. Then we got
a new clue.
I feel like
she said something about drugs at some point.
Rebecca?
I have no interest in drugs or something.
Oh, I bet there's something that says she doesn't take drugs.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Yeah, you're right. Probably coming off the salvia.
A few more questions,
yeah,
please.
Exactly.
Good job. Nice memory.
No, go.
Doesn't take any drugs or
medicines.
It's not.
Nice.
Good job.
So... You don't take any medicines except for prescription painkillers.
Mm. Well, they're not actually for me, they're Ryan's. For some reason, the chemist always makes them up to my name. He's an old gentleman.
Does Ryan need prescription?
Is that code? Is that sex code?
But they're fine.
For your wedding night?
He's young to
what?
That, isn't he?
He doesn't have it badly, but he does need medication from time to time.
What medicine is it?
I can tell you, to be honest. Ryan will know.
So Ryan's the one using the
prescriptions. Ryan's arthritis, and
you
it's
might
a...
might have a word with him and work out exactly what
it's
this
a
medicine
cane?
Is.
Yeah, it's a picture of a cane.
That's it for the time being, thank you.
Most commonly recognized as the symbol for arthritis, and a relevant tool given to people afflicted by it.
What's up, wealthy aardvark?
Yo, sorry you're working.
Yeah, sorry, dude.
I'll ask you a couple more things, please.
Like, how about this?
Tell me about your arthritis.
Oh, you found out about that. Well, yes, I'm old before my time.
It's very unlucky to have it so young.
Well, I take a lot from life, Inspector, and sometimes life likes to give you a little bit back. I mean, it's not too bad, it's not too debilitating, it's mainly some in my right hand, some in my left hand. It's not particularly a problem, makes it difficult to hold small things, though.
What do you take for it?
I get a prescription painkiller.
How often do you need that?
Not often, as and when, I keep...
As and when.
It's not a problem.
Mm-hmm.
As and when.
I keep some here. Think you're above the law?
What?
He said he keeps some here.
Oh, yeah.
I don't
know. No drugs on the... Well, he also keeps alcohol here.
Yeah. Well, we could have pointed this out hours ago and cracked this case.
We tried.
Well, I guess specifically doesn't keep any medicines on site.
So, you don't keep any medicines on site at Atlas?
No.
Except your prescription painkillers.
As and when.
Well,
as in
these
when.
Are not available to the students.
But they are kept on site.
Yes, but they're locked away. They're kept in storage. Nobody would have.
Uh-huh, really? Sure because that? The storeroom seems like it is not very secure.
Ah, the painkillers, right?
Painkillers? Just painkillers. Normal painkillers.
Paracetamol. Codeine.
Morphine.
Well, all right, they're morphine tablets. Yes.
Oh, Jesus, dude.
Okay, Inspector.
Nice.
I know what you're thinking, but there's no way Kate could have had access to them.
Because they're in the storeroom.
Well, not just that. She wouldn't have even known about them. Or where they were.
Sure about that.
Sure about
yes.
that.
People
yes.
tend to
oh,
find
all
out.
Caps.
People tend
so
to find out where the morphine is.
The pieces are starting to come together. Now
keep
I just have
morphine
to work out
in
Kate's
a secure storeroom at Atlas.
Ryan's morphine she got
storeroom
hold of,
isn't particularly secure.
There you go.
All the pieces are coming together.
So storeroom isn't particularly secure, yet you keep your morphine tablets in there. I thought you said no one could get access to the morphine. But they could, quite easily, couldn't they, Ryan?
I didn't mean that storeroom. I meant a different storeroom. I kicked them in there.
Okay. So where was it locked up?
It's upstairs. It's got a combination lock on it. Nobody could have access to it except me and Dad. Nobody.
I might have a look at that, if you don't mind.
Don't mind at all.
God, so bitchy.
A combination locked room, I see. I might have a look around for that.
Well, I
see
think
how
we have
secure
a combination.
Yeah, interesting.
It really is.
How those pieces worked out. Think you got your break in the case, Jenksy.
Yeah.
Ha ha! Doo-dee-doo. All right.
I wanted to remember it.
I know. So disappointing when games don't let you do the final leg of manual effort to prove you're paying attention.
Welcome to the mirror room.
Okay.
This exercise is all about identifying the difference between the image one presents to the world and one's real self.
How much do you guys spend on making this
mirror
room, guys?
As you move through the network of mirrors, practice seeing yourself as a stranger.
No thanks.
The more you separate from your persona, the more aware
the true self.
Of your true
yeah.
desire.
I am
yeah.
a shadow.
I am a shadow.
Charmed with us.
You are not me.
Thee art thou.
Thou art
thee.
Thou art
me. I am free from my past. I am free from my
sin. Free to be free.
I am free from my image. I am free from my past.
Jesse just breaks.
I am free from myself.
Get worked.
I am free.
Yeah, he comes out weeping like a baby.
Reforged.
I understand everything.
This exercise involves the use of liberation masks. You have now completed module 1. Module 2
just take
covers
it with you,
testing,
Jenksy.
Threshold testing, and extreme testing.
Oh.
Please take the notes carefully.
I thought we didn't do extreme testing
anymore.
You look
so saucy. Take the CD.
No, he's afraid. He's got PTSD from being mugged. He can't pick up any round shiny objects anymore. It makes it very difficult to pay for bus fare.
99, or is it just
Can you tell me what you know
I don't know.
The mirror room upstairs?
Oh, you found that then. Well, it's very similar to the costumes, Inspector. It's designed to help the students look at themselves differently.
And what do you do with the mirrors?
You look at yourself, Inspector.
The question is...
Look at yourself.
What you don't do with the mirrors.
As others do.
Answer.
You don't see yourself as you do anymore. It really...
You
the
don't
idea
not have sex
is that
with
you can
them
see yourself...
Wait, what?
Anyway...
So why in a locked room?
To make sure you're not distracted, that's all.
How often is it used?
Not often, a few times a month. Some students find it useful, some don't.
Okay, room locks so students aren't distracted. No rooms, but students. No, that seems relevant.
Room looks so...
Oh, well, mirror room used by students.
Yeah, I mean...
There must be way, some way to link that to, like, students not having access to their drugs? Do we think that's auto-hypnosis?
No, I mean, I don't know, maybe. Maybe. Or used a few times a month.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pushing it.
Yeah, it does feel like a stretch.
But who knows?
Maybe it's... worth going around and talking to other
sure
people first.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Yeah.
What?
No.
What were you thinking?
Wait, what about the dad?
Well, the dad's over here.
Oh, right. Never mind.
Nick, you can't get paper slash plastic bus cards because this takes place in 1996, doesn't it? Isn't
can
it?
You tell
wait,
me
does?
About the
no
room with the mirrors at Atlas? The one with the combination lock.
How did you get in there?
I was given the code for the combination.
Why, right?
Well, nobody else is allowed to know the code, are they?
I'm not in theory.
So how's the room used, mm-hmm, on the course then?
It's a meditation room where the students can reflect on themselves, literally.
Yeah,
it's a little too system literal.
Cool.
You know?
Well,
yeah,
it's too. It's
great.
Not
so you send the students into the room, they put the CD on, they stare into the mirrors. And how long does this last for?
Until the CD finishes or they fall asleep. What else would you like to know?
I mean, I'll add, what is your problem, first of all? Second of all, why are you such a bitch? Just asking questions, I'm doing my goddamn job.
When did Ryan begin to suffer from arthritis?
Ryan doesn't suffer from arthritis.
A hole.
Oh, shit.
The only thing that Ryan suffers from is a pathetic inability to deal with any kind of discomfort. He pulled his back sometime last year. Since then, he's going around telling everybody he suffers from arthritis.
I thought he had medication for it.
Oh, he only has medication because his GP, who is almost as dysfunctional as he is, keeps prescribing it for him.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't believe he really has arthritis?
Not at all.
Is there anything with him talking about drugs on the premises?
I don't think so, but I don't think we have any way to...
Go back. to the... No, I mean...
I don't think we'd have any way to confront him with it, anyway.
No? Okay. Alright. I feel like this music reminds me of all the video game music, but I can't quite place it.
I don't know.
Maybe it just reminds me of this video game. I've just been playing it for a little while.
It sparks such fond memories of this video game.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
Not feeling this quite yet. I think we got other avenues. Like you! Also, I'm sick of talking to James. He's been a dead end since the beginning of the game.
Giles?
James.
A couple more questions.
Also known as Giles, aka Giles.
Do you know anything about a locked room at Atlas Mirrors?
Not off the top of my head, no. I think that's a question for Ryan.
Guess not.
Be back later on, if that's okay.
You guys don't talk about Ryan's work?
She only lets Ryan talk about very specific things.
Yeah. Well, she makes him play guitar in his room.
For the rest of the time, he has to sit in the corner, tied up,
please.
And be mum, I think is the way that they put it.
Did you know about Ryan Round's arthritis?
Arthritis? I don't think Ryan had arthritis.
Had it known.
Do you know about the mirror room?
I mean, she is sleeping with him.
No, I heard about it, but I think it was only for the students that were on the course.
Like your boyfriend! Simon!
Okay, that's it for now. Thank you.
Ah, arthritically playing the guitar.
You know, that came up
the
before.
It did?
Yeah, she said he can barely even play because he's practically distracted.
No, that was the doll making.
You go in and you stare into the mirror and you go into a trance.
Oh.
Then when you're ready, you come back up. So you just...
Oh, so it is.
There's certain times when you're allowed
in. Might be able to ask her.
And only they know the combinations anyway, so you can't really get in.
You don't know the combination.
Well, that seems like something.
That is a lie.
Aha.
Aha.
So you didn't know the combination to the locked mirror room?
Nope.
Except...
Like I'm just fucking...
Haven't you?
Just feeding out that line, Jenksy.
It's a combination.
Yeah.
You see... This sort of thing makes me suspicious, Simon.
Well, this sort of thing makes me wonder about this town where everybody just lies about everything.
It's just part of the course, isn't it? I just wanted to go in there when I was ready.
On your own? Didn't give a number to anyone else?
No.
Simon, there was morphine kept in that room that might have played a part in Kate Vine's death. Did Kate have the number?
This number. Yes, okay. We both went in.
To kiss.
To kiss.
We were trying to
outdo
each other. We both tried to morph it.
What do you mean trying to outdo each other?
It's part of the course. To see how far you can push yourself. To see...
How much morphine?
If you could do something you wouldn't normally do.
Like morphine.
A few months ago. Only that once. I'd never do it again.
Oh shit! That was a major plot event.
So that's how Kate got the morphine. But what exactly does this testing involved.
The clock is ticking.
Involves taking morphine.
Just an hour left to solve this thing.
Just an hour left to solve this thing.
I think I'm going to turn off the air.
Okay. So, Linky, you said no one's supposed to know the non-combination. How do the students get in? But I don't think we have any way to confront them with that. Did you do it? Knocking everything over? Alright, well, let's Ryan play in his room. Ryan practically just brags.
Let's Ryan play.
I know. Alright, so let's
wait.
Thank you. Probably be back later. Just a few more questions, if you don't mind.
It's been open this whole time.
Oh, I thought it was closed.
Huh.
What's the matter?
Well, he didn't give us a new clue, is the thing. So I'm wondering, I guess the hour just changed.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to see if there's any plot events.
You need to see if anybody's in the woods doing morphine.
I mean, fucking Peter Rand is going to be asleep in his chair, snoring and watching British Matlock. Nope, bar's still empty.
Cat file?
Yeah, brother.
He doesn't seem like he would like cat file.
Oh, right, I forgot to ask about the arthritis, because...
Ask about a few more things, please.
It doesn't matter. She shouldn't know we allowed to have a combination code.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
Tell me more about this sweaty IT man. Seems to be quite the gadfly. So I'm going to ask him about the arthritis. I don't think that's going to pull anything up, but... I want to, like...
A couple more questions, if that's okay?
I want the hour to change, and then Jenks wanders into, like, a fight scene, and then there's just a prolonged, like, five-minute sequence.
Right. He's got arthritis?
Apparently.
Oh, I didn't know. I hadn't noticed he had any problems.
I don't know.
Be back later on, if that's okay.
Huh? Suddenly things are driving down a quiet, idyllic neighborhood street.
I mean, that sounded like a truck. At least.
Yeah. Can you call Ryan on his bullshit arthritis? Hey!
That's the thing, is I don't think we can. It's not a clue.
Yeah. It's like difficult sometimes. Has arthritis... Maybe. Alright, and skateboards apparently are a thing we're doing now. Maybe something to do with the guitars?
Maybe.
Dabs and playing the...
Mabat has arthritis in his hands. No.
The thing is, like, once you... I feel like it might just be one... I don't know if one clue will have more than one contradiction. Mirror room used a few times a month. Is there something like students don't have access to drugs?
We already did that one.
Yeah, but maybe like a deeper one? I mean, he just said that him and Kate have done morphine. How is that not a clue?
Yeah. Oh, what about the auto-hypnosis thing?
With what?
Didn't, Legolas say that it was,
Oh, actually... Maybe,
Thank you. Probably
maybe we should go
later.
Talk to the dad, because he said they don't use auto-hypnosis at all.
Okay. Yeah, that's good.
And I've been waiting to stick that one.
Ask you a couple more things, please.
Yes, he says mirror room used for meditation. Emma's criticism of the... No. Yeah, but we already
we did that one.
Yeah, we've already sort of I think we've already gotten the clue for doesn't keep medicine on site.
Was it grayed out?
With this guy or the other guy?
No, I don't know. I was just asking. I mean, it's possible we could ask both of them about it. Right?
Maybe that would have to do with... We didn't get any new clues. It put us in front of the bar. I don't think it always puts you in front of the bar. What's going on here?
Outside?
Yeah, it's so loud. All of a sudden.
That's not garbage trucks coming. They don't come now, do they?
No, well, it's Monday pickup.
Tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
What is this key ring? Tell me, Simone. Never come across anyone involved with the occult. Did we already try this?
I'm pretty sure.
Isn't she the one that said about the fairy spells?
I don't know. No, yeah, we...
I already tried this?
Yeah, you did.
So we've got the mirror room.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
If you go in your inventory, you can, like...
What about, trying to talk to a crazy girl again?
No, you can't visit her.
You can't?
Yeah. It's not a location.
What about crazy dude?
I guess so. Maybe, I mean...
Like we got a lot to give it to ask him about.
I just feel like he keeps giving us these bum leads.
Oh.
Aha!
Oh.
Yes.
What is it?
Fight scene.
Fight scene.
Oh, that's their meeting.
What's up, Chumley?
Universes are colliding.
The
they're not allowed to be in the same place.
Yeah. So, how's it going?
Who'd you meet there?
Excuse me.
Nothing to search, though.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Who was that guy? Maybe you're supposed to go look around.
Yeah.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
I was hoping a cutscene might happen. This, like, filter is hurting
my
eyes.
Yeah, it is pretty bad.
Well, I don't know if it's... I mean, it's certainly harder to record stuff at night. But it's very clear they just recorded...
I mean, they recorded, like, two shots at each location. So it's probably more
and
about,
they're
like,
just putting
having everyone on set
deeper
to
blue
do it.
Filter. Yeah.
Yeah, twice.
So they just recorded everything once.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, which is really great if you need to make a game very cheaply. Like...
What the crap? Wait, go left down West Street. I don't think that usually is allowed.
That's
no?
That's her house, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, I think it is. But there's nothing here.
So there was nothing on the bar? Well,
no.
Where did we find that guy? In the woods, I guess.
Maybe we should try and follow him instead.
Yeah. Back through the woods.
I'll just take the long way around so we don't miss anything.
Woods Lane. Nope.
I just wanted to check. Figured if we were doing it, might as well go all out. Nope, he's not in his usual spot.
He's not in his hobo camping spot.
Okay.
There we go.
Scream! Go! Yes! Fight scene.
Or birth scene?
Just keep pushing. Keep pushing.
Nope.
Keep pushing. You can push it all the way in, Tom, if you want to.
Holy shit. This is
excellent.
Too real.
Excuse me. Would someone care to tell me exactly what's going on here?
Don't come any closer.
That man needs a doctor.
No, he doesn't.
He kind of does.
I don't need a doctor. I'm fine. Go away.
My head is even
is
rounder
this?
Than Ryan.
A test of what?
What does it look like? It's a threshold test.
Aha!
A threshold test. I thought you were supposed to be good at working things out. Inspector Jenks.
It's Jenks,
so
actually.
So this would be for Atlas, would it? Kyle?
You disappear now.
Hey. It's not a good idea to talk to a police inspector like that.
Do you want me to make you? It's okay, Tom. Mr. Jenks won't be bothering us anymore.
Don't make any rash commitments.
Nice. Everyone's dropping their keys. Oh, everybody's keys.
Thank you for...
Well. You really should take more care of your things,
have,
Ryan.
Like, buckets full of
is
keys.
Is your keys, Carla?
Yeah.
No.
What?
I'm keeping them, though. Law of the jungle.
Yep, this shit's mine now.
I got a different
clicker.
So that's
clicker. Threshold testing, is it? Sticking a skewer through your hand? I could just ask Ryan or Paul directly about this, but I think I'll bide my time. See what I can do with this key fob first.
Key fob?
I think I know
what's
what
a key fob?
Key fob.
Key fob.
Your key fob.
Key fob.
Possession is 9/10 of the law.
Drive his car. Drive it all around.
You wake him up. You wake up old man Ryan.
Bingo. Well, Ryan, what have you been up to? Be very interesting to see how he explains this one.
Yeah.
That's some pretty weak bribery.
Well, depends on...
Those better be monthly installments. Weekly installments? Like, that's not a lot of money. Maybe in a small town.
She doesn't want to bleed him dry.
They're millionaires!
I don't know that they are millionaires, considering they keep having to, like, swindle.
That's true.
People.
But who else is millionaires?
A couple more questions, if that's okay.
The fuck
Would
is
you
this?
Like to explain what this is, please, Ryan? £500 intended for Kate. It fell out of your car. So I assume that's your car on the driveway at Brandon House?
I suppose so.
So why were you going to give Kate £500, Ryan?
It fell out of your car.
It was just a little incentive, that's all. Just a little incentive.
Not very little, Ryan. £500.
That's fairly...
She
it's a little.
A very good student. We heard that she was leaving. We wanted to give her something.
But you didn't.
Well, obviously not.
Are you sure there wasn't any other reason you might want to give her this? Personal reason?
No!
Well, I'd like to keep hold of this for a little while, if you don't mind.
Well, don't consider it a bribe, will you, Inspector?
Well, it's not something I can redeem, so no, I will not.
Hello, this is Kate Vine.
Jenks, he is a pretty good actor, though.
Yeah.
He might be able to
He could be anyone.
He might have to take off that hat, which I'm not sure he's capable of.
Hello, my name is Ryan Rand. What? But I'm Ryan Rand. No. I'm Ryan Rand. Breaks down. It's true. It's all true.
Free car. What does this check thing say? I didn't see.
No ulterior motive. It was an incentive. I think those were the two relevant ones. So we need to find an ulterior motive. Or we need to ask Dad about that.
Yeah.
Be back later on, if that's okay.
The wife first.
Thank you.
No place for guilt in business, Inspector.
Okay, that's it for now. Thank you.
Simon drops things. Ah. Where did James put all those boxes?
ask you a couple more things, please?
Actually,
I
feel like it's
open. Yeah. Ooh. Suddenly there's a breeze.
Now, why do you think Ryan might want to give Kate a check for £500?
I really have no idea.
Really?
Where did you find it?
Just outside.
You better ask him.
You think Ryan was interested romantically in Kate?
I know he has a weakness for blondes, but I didn't think it had gone so far as his offering them cash.
A brunette?
Yeah.
Is that the contradiction?
I mean, yeah. Just her, what about her picture? Not much. No.
Well, you think he might know that she's not blonde? Costume party.
Yeah, I mean, presumably she was wearing a wig that night, but I don't think we're there yet. There's probably a few steps in between.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Photo.
Just a few more questions, if you don't mind.
That seems a little not like game logic, though.
Best not to ask Rebecca about
the money for Dave. Thank you. Probably be back later.
I mean, probably go ask the friend. You're just gonna hang out in there. I need a minute to myself.
James,
I'm just gonna go in the basement.
The goods.
Sitting here.
I glanced at the clue while you were out of the room. I was like, just where did James keep the boxes?
Boxes?
Yeah. Traded off with the other guy.
Wait, go further up.
I did that.
Oh.
That's the other greenhouse.
Wait, I don't remember seeing this one.
We came here really early in the game. That's where we found the mirrors. Oh, what? I didn't notice that last time.
So James is interested in poppy pods, is he?
Poppy pods.
He's got some explaining to do.
Poppy pads.
Those are some fucking huge poppy pods.
You just have to smoke one of these to be high for the rest of your life.
That's actually not
what
people want out of drugs.
It's a great deal.
That is not.
Be high forever.
We've glanced at the menu maybe a few times.
Tell me about poppy pods.
Tell me about several boxes of dried poppy pods in the greenhouse back there.
Say poppy pods. Say it. Reply poppy pods.
Take some if you want. What are they for, James?
Decoration. Why?
Decoration.
It's a big market for them among the over 70s.
So what are you doing with them?
selling them to grannies.
Okay, James, let's just cut to the chase. Are you extracting opium from them?
Me? I can honestly say I've never done anything like that, Inspector.
Sure about that?
Scout's honour.
And who was the guy delivering them?
A friend. Someone gave them to him. He asked me if I wanted them. I said I'd have a look and see if I liked them.
You just thought you'd have a look? No particular reason?
I'm a plant scientist, that's what I do.
Have you ever sold them to anyone else?
I only got them a few minutes ago.
In the past. You know Kate's body had opium in the blood when it was found?
No, I didn't. Hey, that's nothing to do with me.
Let's hope not.
Ooh. Selling the poppy pods to pensioners.
Poppy pods? Selling the poppy pods to pensioners.
Poppy pods used for decoration. Pods from a friend who didn't want them, never extracted opium from the pods. Doesn't seem like we... have anything to twist his arm about the poppy pods.
The poppy pods.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
The past.
Whoa. Daylight flashed through my eyes for a moment there.
In the past.
Couple more questions, if that's okay?
We've used the hint system like two or three times, I guess.
What do you know about poppy pods?
Poppy pods.
Poppy pods.
Poppy pods.
Poppy pods.
Poppy pods. Everyone say poppy pods.
Using them?
No.
You're pretty old, though.
Make him say poppy pods.
What do you think about
Be
puppy
back later
paws?
On, if that's okay.
Small, squishy puppy paws.
It's like saying pop heads, but with more peas.
Yeah.
More plosives. Even more plosive than pop heads.
Poppy pads.
Puppy pots.
Puppy
I guess
pods.
If you said puppy pop heads, then you're out of luck. Ooh. Poppy pods.
What do you know about poppy pods?
Poppy pods.
Go on.
Ever come across
Go
anyone
on.
Trying to sell them or anything like that? Maybe even in here.
Oh.
Not that I remember.
Then why do you look so weirdly smug about it?
Go on.
Why are we not asking Rebecca
later.
About it? Do your job, Jinxie.
No, he doesn't want to mess up any familial relations.
That's bullshit.
He knows they're having a hard time, man. He's sensitive. He's like, I'm not gonna. Those kids look like they're gonna. They have something
things,
good.
Strange question. Have you ever known of anyone selling dried poppy pods?
Poppy pods.
Poppy pods.
Don't think so. Isn't that opium?
Kind of.
It's okay.
It's really not.
It's okay.
I'm pretty sure you can't just smoke a poppy like. I think
well,
you have to like, do
he,
a lot of work to get opium out of poppies, and it's only very specific
opium.
Kinds of poppies.
Odd question, but have you ever seen anyone handling dried poppy pods?
Poppy pods? As in, for opium? No. Though, James
Somebody
did
do
have
a supercut.
Opium tea once, I think.
Where did he get it from?
Oh, I don't know. I didn't ask. James does his own thing.
What does opium tea taste like?
I don't know.
Don't
try it.
Really?
I didn't want to risk it, did I? But I went to hospital once. I had codeine. And
interesting.
Oh, anaphylactic shock.
Really?
The doctor said it was an opium derivative.
Oh.
You're a terrible liar.
Can't keep that straight. You idiot.
You
tall, pale idiot.
You said, isn't it?
Yeah.
But you're allergic to opiates, Simon. Opium. You didn't take the morphine at all, did you?
He palmed it.
No, I didn't. Kate did, though.
I thought you were trying to outdo each other. That was the point, wasn't it?
We weren't trying to outdo each other as such.
Go on.
Just trying to do each other.
Ryan wanted me to test Kate. to see how far she would go to be prime candidate.
What candidate?
Prime candidate. It means the best person in the group, basically.
What do you mean, tester?
But you do it in pairs. One person's the tester, it's me. And the other person's
the...
Oh,
thumb ring.
Victim.
Well, it's so not like that. It's completely consensual. It's just boundary testing. Ryan wanted me to test Kate.
Because they thought she was the best student.
Well, maybe. I don't know. I just did what I was told, okay?
Except you decided to give her morphine. To break the law.
Well, I can't change that now, can I? She didn't die of a morphine overdose, did she?
She died because she drowned. But she drowned for reasons that aren't clear.
Atlas seemed to have this all neatly worked out. If Simon's telling the truth, Atlas are lighting the fuse and then retiring to a safe distance, letting students test themselves and push themselves to their limits while avoiding all comeback. Is this what happened to Kate?
Tell me about the prime candidates.
Hello. I wish to be your prime
candidate. A few more questions.
I've heard some things about the crowns worn by prime candidates.
What are prime candidates?
The best of the bunch. The peaches.
Yeah.
To be a prime candidate.
Success. We have a special relationship with.
No, stop.
We provide them with our best students, and they get an instant job.
And what do you get out of it?
Well, it's a little kickback. It's just business, Inspector.
Just Poppy Pods, Inspector.
I mean, that's not
reverse
really
kickback.
That's a payout, not a kickback.
Thank you. Probably will be back later.
Excuse me.
Did you see what Nick said?
Oh, God, no.
Peaches.
Stop.
The prime students.
No.
The cranberries.
The cranberries?
The durians.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Dragon fruit.
Tell me what a prime candidate is.
You're learning a lot, aren't you, Inspector?
I think I should start charging you.
He's just here to have fun.
The most potential.
And what benefits do they get from that?
Well, they get the top job.
Which is?
Well, we have a deal with various multinationals. We train students to be exceptional, truly exceptional. And they get a wonderful top job. It seems very simple.
Top job.
And how do you decide who the prime candidate is?
Do you test students?
No.
Did you ever, say, ask Simon to test Kate, for instance?
Oh, you've actually been speaking to Simon, haven't you? I really wouldn't trust anything that Simon Thompson says. You know, he spent the best part of 2 months trying to undermine Kate. No. Simon Thompson, it really isn't my place to speculate, but if you're looking for motives, Inspector, he certainly had a few motives. More than I.
A motive to kill her, do you know?
Now, that's very interesting, Inspector. Well, that's up to you to decide.
Come on, it's time to ask about Poppy Pods.
Know anything about Poppy Pods? Come across anyone selling them or anything?
Poppy Pods? Well, don't tell anyone, Inspector. but I hear that you can make opium out of those. Why do you ask?
Doesn't matter.
He just blinked 35 times.
Yeah. But then again, maybe that you can't, like Kiji said, you can't cross-reference statements, but...
Yeah.
I feel like, I guess that would just get too, there would just be too much.
I didn't think that would bring anything up, but...
Go back to drugs, the earlier drugs.
Did the game freeze?
I don't know. Did it? Yes. Looks like.
Did the keyboard die, maybe? Oh, it's back.
No?
Might be the keyboard.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
It's all very slow. Might be. Yeah, it's working again now. Strange. Let's see.
Good job.
What's the tip say?
What?
What?
Nothing. It does seem like it's being a little weird.
Yeah, it's freaking out. The simulation is breaking down.
Oh, yeah. Maybe we should restart it.
Questions,
or
if that's
crashes.
Okay.
Restart it on purpose. So that it doesn't happen in the middle of a cutscene.
So.
Do you know what a prime candidate is?
At Atlas. It's the best student.
And what does that mean?
It means they get a guaranteed job with a very good salary. Well, that's the idea anyway.
But?
Mostly they aren't up to it.
What happens then?
They get sacked.
I got sacked. By which I mean they put a bag over my head and...
Be back later on if I...
Tickled me.
And stole my form.
I was really...
Do you need to look for batteries?
No, I was gonna...
Watch the intro?
I was gonna put the game.
Yeah.
So... No, this seems to be working fine.
Yeah.
So it probably was the game? Maybe not. No. Maybe we should get new batteries. That might be an issue.
You don't know where they are?
Nope. I don't know. Vote skip. What does that exclamation point mean?
Contradiction. Font choice and like the...
Don't forget to use the map and the tips.
Like the... What do you call it?
Not grandma.
If you don't mind.
We haven't asked her about the prime candidate.
Do you know what a prime candidate is at Atlas?
Yes, it's what every student wants to be. It's the best student. Apparently you get a great high-paid job afterwards. I don't think that really happens, though.
Did you know anyone in the running to be prime candidate?
What, like Simon? I don't think they bid Simon, to be honest. Well, he's got too many morals, and you can't have both at Atlas.
Does he? She only went once, so maybe you should ask her not that. Only went once, but doesn't...
Well, I don't know. He could have told her about it.
Sure.
I feel like this is not.
Probably good. Not. It just came in my head. Figured try it. Yeah. Well.
I feel like we've asked everybody.
I think you're supposed to call the chief.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
I don't know for sure. The chief might just strictly be a hint system.
Really?
Yeah, I don't think it has any plot. I mean, I guess you do get to hear the voice acting.
Got something interesting, Jenks?
Very much so, sir. An interesting discovery in Ryan's car. A check for £500 from Ryan made out to Kate.
Why? How does he explain that?
He said it was an incentive. Apparently he'd heard she was thinking of leaving the course.
What made her so special that they were willing to pay her to stay?
Just a good student, I suppose.
Nah, doesn't add up. £500 is a lot more than an incentive, Jenks. You can buy questions in Parliament for that kind of money. Sounds pretty desperate. Keep on a Ryan about it. Oh, and get yourself another drink.
Another drink. Thanks, Chief.
What?
Another drink. Thanks, Chief. I'm gone. Goodbye.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Never had something I've been trying to test students. Had a very good job. So something between these two things, Mendel's a little, no ulterior reading. Oops.
No, that's... It was his explanation.
I feel like it... I just want it... to
really
be something between these two things. He wanted her to be the prime candidate. Well, I mean, there's also the affair, so maybe we should just...
Yeah. Wait, did we asked Emma about the check and what did she say? Because if that was hush money, she's involved in that.
Yeah, so you think we should ask her?
Tell me about this.
Ah,
that's all for the moment. Thank you.
Do we have to, like, tie on?
I don't know. That's not tonight.
Oh, it's not?
No, recycling is Thursday.
Oh, true. I guess I just assumed.
A couple more questions, if that's okay.
Emma wouldn't know about the money. Can't even ask her about it.
What?
Be back later on, if that's okay. Okay, that's it for now. Thank you.
Something.
We just have to keep it Ryan, I think. I mean, it's got to be a contradiction with him.
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
What about the morphine room and Kate? The money?
Doesn't say anything well.
No. I mean, I guess this is a
oh, said Kate enjoyed the course and appeared happy.
Fuck. Mosquito.
Yeah. Go back. Kate enjoyed the course and appeared happy. One of the things on the check is I heard Kate was thinking about leaving.
Yeah, that's what we just did.
No, you did the other one.
Oh.
What? I mean, that is literally a contradiction, so. It would have to be like Kate.
I know, yeah.
There's also students aren't tested.
We already tried that though.
Yeah.
I mean, ask her about the screwdriver and the homebrew and the key.
Students aren't being coerced at all.
Aha.
I mean,
definitely this one.
Yay.
Yeah. So, students aren't coerced or bribed in any way.
No.
Except Kate.
I'm not sure what you mean.
You said you were going to give Kate the £500 as an incentive. That's coercion, isn't it?
I really don't think you could call it coercion, Inspector. It was an incentive, that's all, a little encouragement.
So, how often do you use incentives?
Okay, incentive is probably the wrong word. The money was just to see how Kate would respond. It was part of her assessment.
Students are tested.
We have to assess students as they progress. We don't use conventional methods like sitting an exam or anything like that. People pay for this course per session. We have to know if they're committed or not.
So you're assessing their progress and testing their commitment?
Yes, we are. We have to. This is a business, not a charity.
So Ryan's claiming the money was part of Kate's assessment. And did this assessment also involve threshold testing, I wonder? Or was the money for something else?
Wait, but we didn't get a new clue?
No.
Go back to the $500. £500. Was it added to the other thing? The student, it must have been added to the students aren't course in any way one.
The hell was it?
That one. Gave money to test assessor.
Nice.
Aha. Well, which one is it, Ryan? Do you test students or not?
Fight me, IRL, bro.
Including Kate.
Yes.
Why was she being tested?
She was being tested because... because we wanted to see if she was good enough to become prime candidate, okay?
So Kate was willing to be prime candidate.
Yes.
And did you ask Simon to test her?
Yes, I did. But I didn't ask him to do anything stupid. He knew it was against course rules.
How far did you ask him to push her?
I didn't ask him to push her. I asked him to test her. There's a huge difference.
Blown out your mic, dude.
If Simon decided to give her too much caffeine or morphine or whatever, that's his responsibility. So if he did anything wrong, it was his own responsibility. He did it with his own mind and his own hand. We had nothing to do with it!
Oh shit! Wait, that means we're...
Midnight, and still no suspect. Unless you count everyone I've interviewed. It's no surprise that Ryan wants to avoid any suggestion of being responsible for Kate's death. But I wonder if the man protests just a little too much.
Alright, we're gonna have to walk around. But also, it's midnight, so... I guess we lost.
What?
The case has to be solved by midnight.
Maybe till midnight is up.
Yes.
I mean...
don't think that's how time works.
But it's not timed, is it?
Not really, but in the plot it is.
Right, but I don't think you can... I thought it only progresses once.
Yes. Right. But the plot is that he has to solve it by midnight.
Right.
Ask you a couple more things, please.
How do you think you'd have reacted if you'd found out that Kate had been chosen to be prime candidate?
Is that...
was she? I'm just asking how you think you'd react.
I don't know. I wouldn't react in any way, really. I'm not bothered. I don't think she was, though.
What makes you think that?
Well, it's just an impression I got. You know, she's a bit flaky, to be honest. It's just not really prime candidate material.
Are we about to...
hmm?
Are they?
Thank you. Probably
thank
be back
you.
Later.
Thank you.
Do you know whether Kate was in the running to be prime candidate or not?
I don't, but I do think she would have been chosen. Just because she was... you know, Kate.
You didn't discuss it with Kate?
No. No, she never talked about Atlas.
Kate didn't discuss Atlas course and something. It's gotta be something.
Maybe they already did that. Yeah.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
What do you know about prime candidates there, Jimbo?
Just a few more questions, if you don't mind.
Wouldn't know about kids' prime time.
That's
well,
a moment. Thank
you're
you.
Useful as ever, James. Just keep up the good work.
Poppy pods. He gave up poppy pods.
Oh, well, Linkiji said, oops. Linkiji said she knows Kate used auto-hypnosis.
All right, that's a good, yeah, that's right, a good call.
Go back there after I finish up.
Ask about a few
with
more
the
things,
elder
please.
Statesman.
Was Kate a prime candidate?
Well, as Ryan has probably already told you, yes, she was.
Did you ask Simon to test her?
Yes, it's
did
company
you ask
policy.
Simon to tickle
leaders
her?
Don't get involved.
And it covers your back, of course.
Well, nobody knows the students better than they do, Inspector. It's much better to let them just work it out among themselves.
It isn't very professional to force students to test each other to the point where one of them gets killed, Paul.
We don't force students to do anything that they don't want to do, Inspector.
So you don't force them into being tested?
No. We don't encourage anybody to hurt or offend anybody else here.
You don't use threshold testing, for instance?
No. If Simon Thompson went too far with Kate, that's his responsibility, not ours. He's the one you should be speaking to, if truth be told. I don't trust him myself.
Mm-hmm. Don't use threshold testing. Alright, well, let's go
back. Be
back
later on, if that's okay.
Emma, let's see if we get anything out of there.
How about students not encouraged to hurt each other with what the fuck I just saw in the woods?
Yeah, well, they could be going off script.
Couple more questions, if that's okay.
I mean, that auto... We'll see about the auto-hypnosis. It'd be nice if that worked. Yeah. It doesn't say she used it at Atlas or whatever. Alright, well, he's
thank
got
you. Probably be back later.
An interesting and full-featured response to, that prime candidate question. So, that seems like a good lead.
A few more questions, please. Did you know Kate Vine was a prime candidate?
No.
Thanks.
That's it for the time being. Thank you.
Well, oops. Maybe it might be as simple as something in between the two prime candidate statements.
Maybe.
I'll ask you a couple more things, please.
Best students, well-paid job, Atlas receives kickback. Students not encouraged to hurt each other.
Wait, there was threshold testing and Simon or Wes's face has a low threshold for pain. I don't know if that's related, but how do you know? I mean,
yeah, but that's not a contradiction. Yeah.
No, it's not. Just seems like it's trying to draw your attention to it, that's all. Wait, what was who couldn't become a professional?
Ryan. Guitar player.
Oh.
Curbs ideals over morality. didn't know about Simon's home. A few times, possibly keep us drunk. I don't know. I got nothing.
I'm not sure either.
I think we asked everybody about prime candidates. Of the people.
Thank you. Probably be back later.
Wait. Actually, now that I think about it, I don't think we've been everywhere since the hour turned over. I think we've gone on our traditional spirit walk.
Go woods walking.
Twig sifting, he calls it. Damn it. Turned up buckus. Anything new in the cabinets for my perusal? No? That's too bad. The side door. It has to be the door to the right.
There's never been anything in this room.
Well, except for the class that one time.
Oh, right. Maybe there's something upstairs again.
Key in the combination, Jenks.
That's it.
Leave the mirror room, disappointed. Trunk, 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 trunk. Well, this sucks.
Is he just not taking our calls anymore?
Yeah, I guess he's being frumpy.
Let's go to the pub. Oh, we've been to the pub. Or have we been
in your pub? Yeah, I guess we haven't checked the restaurant. Or you found those drugs, though, so it seems like... Probably that.
So cute!
Don't know, it must be Emma. It must be, it has to be.
A few more questions, if you don't mind.
Is it time to check the tips?
Sure.
Nick asked.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
Can't be an interrogation.
Yeah, it does seem like you should be able to contradict Paul.
Yeah, like we don't even have a tip for that. Wonder what Paul thinks about prime candidates. Wait.
We talked to him about prime candidates.
Is it confused or did we somehow not ask?
Maybe
a few more questions, if you don't mind.
Puppy pots. Well, maybe there's a contradiction. Prime candidates. Kate was being tested for prime candidates. Wait, didn't he say Simon was undermining her?
I don't know.
He did say that. know where it would show up.
Suspected Kate of trying to play him. No Samara's use. No interest in scrying. Only met Kate a few times. I don't know, how could she be prime candidate material?
What are you? Listen, this is England.
Yeah.
There's nothing be contradictory about those statements.
Well, I guess maybe.
In our culture.
So Insane Court said, I think this is one of the times the clues are poorly worded. Maybe we should let the chief tell us if we're at least on the right track. I mean, I don't know. In games like this, I always feel bad when you're just sort of puttering in front of a live audience.
Yeah, it's true.
Hello, Jenks. Yes, I'm still up. Thanks for asking.
Chief Ryan admitted that he asked Simon to test Kate to see if she was good enough to be prime candidate, but he's throwing it all back on Simon. Says it was up to Simon about how he went about testing her.
Very convenient. What does Paul say?
He pretty much backs Ryan up. He claims they don't do any threshold testing.
Well, that's a load of horse droppings. He knows you're onto him, Jenks, which means you're getting somewhere at last. It's only taken you until midnight, but well done nonetheless. Listen, call me back. I'm watching an old movie, but Christopher Lee's only just turned up, so I'll be here for another hour or so, yeah?
Okay, Chief. I'll call again.
Yeah, bye.
I mean, so that just seems like it wants us to...
keep on Paul.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's gotta be some of Paul. Yeah, what happened to the captions?
Maybe
a couple more questions, if that's okay.
I was wondering about that. I thought maybe it was just bugged. Given a well-paying job, best student. So, I don't know. We just got this, so it has to be attached to that.
What? We just got what? Kate was being tested for a candidate?
Students not encouraged to hurt each other. I mean, is it something with the students not encouraged to hurt each other and morality doesn't exist?
Maybe.
But I just think... not exactly a contradiction.
No. Where was that?
Somewhere in the middle. Students encouraged to free themselves from the guild, but I mean, that's not really much of a contradiction.
Yeah.
Might as well try it.
Wait.
Unless it's that, test designed to reveal psychological issues. But they don't seem to count that now, because we're talking strictly about the prime candidate question.
Yeah.
Nick says, I think I see it. It might be the statements don't literally contradict each other, but there's contradiction in it. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's what, getting it.
Yeah. Try the thing we have with the violence one, just to see.
This one?
Yeah.
No.
Maybe something with that. What about that with the psychological testing? Nope, other way.
What?
Keep going right. Or Lisa couldn't handle the course techniques. Or anything about threshold testing? I mean, maybe I just couldn't understand the tip. You mean the tip that what does Paul think of the prime candidates? Yeah, I feel like I kind of get what you're going for, Nick.
What does Paul think about prime candidates?
I mean, so
prime candidates are the best students.
You could try that with go over to leaders don't get involved in testing students, but I thought we tried that.
You did try that. Well, like, I was looking for something where he was like, Kate isn't material, but he seems to always talk about her like she is smart and... What's more about Kate?
The only other thing about Kate, I think, with him is the, the costume bag. Has some stuff about her.
There is.
That's the thing about her trying to flirt with him. I mean, that, he that's around here about this.
I mean, there's something about her trying to play him.
Yeah, that's...
But, like, that's not inconsistent with...
Yeah. It's further back. It's this stuff.
It's where?
I don't remember exactly, but it's not that far into it. Wasn't her picture. I really thought it was on the costume bag, but I guess not. Scroll down on the costume bag one. Nope.
I mean, it was something about...
Maybe it was
her flirting with him.
Yeah. Yeah, it just appears to have disappeared.
Here you go.
No.
Okay, that's
blank.
It for now. Thank you.
I'm gonna go call the chief again with the subtitles on. Just to make sure I'm not missing anything here. I'm a little embarrassed. Not. Keep pressing. Wait, what's happening? I think that was like a spoiler.
A few more questions, please. Thank you.
Well, I looked at the chief thing and it said keep pushing about the threshold testing.
Try that. Oh.
So it must be that with something else. But what? We tried. Oh. Did we try?
Yes, we tried that.
Nick, I assume you were going to say the threshold testing is definitely part of it.
Yeah, sure, tell us. Thanks. Thanks for your cautious and thoughtful use of clues. So it is the threshold one.
But what?
Well, they sent... What's his face to test What do we have about Simon's testing her? Didn't he say shit about that, though?
Nothing that populated into a clue, I don't think. Once more from the top.
Okay, was being tested. I mean, we tried that.
Yeah, but that's the same statement. Yeah. Are they really gonna do that?
I mean, no. Don't use threshold testing and. What?
I have no idea. Oh, wait a minute. No, damn it. CD in mirror. Did the CD say anything about threshold?
Oh, yeah.
Fuck.
Nice.
Should have just rewatched that.
You say you don't endorse threshold testing, that's the phrase, isn't it?
Yes.
Except you do, Paul, because you told me that the students use that CD in the mirror room. I've listened to that CD, and it very clearly mentions threshold testing. You keep batting this away, Paul. We don't really use hypnosis. The students aren't really tested, but I am this close to launching a full-scale investigation.
Look, we get a kickback from these students, and they have to be exceptional. Of course we have to test them. That doesn't mean we do anything illegal. What do you think we do? Bump off the ones we don't like?
Well, that depends on how far you push them, doesn't it?
Well, we certainly don't kill them. Nobody here wanted Kate dead.
I'm sure they didn't. But what do you expect, Paul, when you put students under that much pressure?
She was a very, very valuable student. She was worth a lot to the business.
Really? And how much would that be?
£500.
Really want to know, £50,000.
She was worth £50,000?
Yes.
What, you were selling her?
Of course we were selling her. You don't get this,
human
do you?
Human slavery.
We make perfect employees. Month after month, that's all we do.
What do you mean, perfect employees?
What big business needs, Inspector, more than anything else, is none of this altruistic, goody-goody crap. What we look for is people with ambition. No ethics. Push. Greed is good. All right? We don't deal with all this comfort stuff. The survival of the fittest. That's all there is. There's no higher purpose, no big plan. There's nothing at the end of the rainbow. Except what you have and you can enjoy in the here and now.
And what do you enjoy now, Paul?
Peaches. Cantaloupe. You're gonna have to excuse me. Inspector, I'm a very busy man. I've got work to do.
Oh! That's the first time Jenks has let his facade fall. To show the inner salt within.
Lovely man, your father.
Shut the gate on your way out.
Fight me IRL, Jenks. Uh-oh. It's finally happening.
He's doing his level best to shut this place down. Get rid of him. He's a policeman. We can't just... You saw this, Ryan. You man up, and you sort it. Tonight.
I mean, it's already sorted. You just have to wait another, like, 35 minutes.
Yeah. Classic Jenks move.
Classic Jenks-y. Kyle.
That doesn't sound good. Two totally morally bankrupt men are plotting to get rid of me. It's midnight. I don't have any backup and I don't even have a mobile phone. This is potentially quite bad. And what's Kyle got to do with it? I think I might make my way over to Atlas while Ryan isn't there. Maybe lock myself in.
With what? There's no locks. Emma, protect me. Hide me in the fruit cellar. Help me, fat, sweaty IT guy. Somebody. Jenks is all alone.
I suppose it was too much to hope that Ryan had left the place open.
Just look at the ground. He probably dropped his keys. They're constantly doing that.
Yeah, I mean, he's made note of that. Kyle has the keys. I threw them to him. Or maybe not anymore, I guess.
Nope. There we go.
Or maybe he does.
I found a baby bird nest.
Yeah.
Prove to me that you're man enough to do this, Kyle, and then you can deal with that ridiculous police inspector.
What is this?
What the hell? Scotland Yard. Not hell. Hello, Ryan.
Hello, Inspector. What are you doing here?
Inspecting. Come on.
Not really concerned about.
You're not really gonna like try to
the best stop thing you can do with the knife.
Go away. Leave us to it.
Knife.
What?
That knife gives me a perfect right to stick my nose in, investigate, and interfere.
Maybe
this
the knife
is
or
all
stop.
Part of the Atlas course. It's a physical endurance exercise.
Chopper, chop knife. Him on the wrist.
The knife, Kyle.
Kyle.
Drop it!
Drop it.
Not looking 100% brilliant for you, Ryan.
Well, please, Inspector,
really
you've poked your nose into Atlas's affairs enough times to know that imaginative flair is part of the course's success. Our lessons are reinforced by a unique emotional experience.
Terror?
It's an extremely evocative tool.
Well, it's a good job you're not in charge of the national
what is
curriculum.
That? You're not going to ask her what she's doing
yeah.
or, like, to do. If that was part of.
But believe me, Atlas had nothing to do with the deaths of those people.
Eyewitness account of a satanic sacrifice in the woods. That's not what we call circumstantial evidence, Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
Simon. Now, I saw Simon walking home with Kate last Friday after the meeting. Now, Simon had some strange idea that he was in the running to become prime candidate. Well, a knob of butter has more chance of becoming prime minister. Oh, wait.
So are you telling me that...
Simon killed her? Well, it seems reasonable. It's likely, isn't it?
Any more likely than you, Ryan.
Wait, but isn't presumably that a student?
Pig!
Stab him.
Police brutality.
Stab Kyle.
Are you okay?
Really?
Who was that
mysterious Jenksy, what is your problem? You suck at everything.
The ghost of Kate.
You're not going to interview that person? What is wrong with you?
This would be better if he were just like a citizen investigator. Like, I am the police. What can I do? My hands are tied.
It would be indecorous to ask a lady when she was held at right after she was held at knife point to explain what
ask
the fuck is going
things,
on.
Please. What would you say if I said it's been suggested that you were seen walking home with Kate after Atlas last Friday?
What? By who?
The same person who suggested that you wanted Kate out of the picture because you found out she was in the running to be prime candidate.
Who said that?
Just a question.
I didn't think I was in the running. It was Ryan, wasn't it?
I am in no position to say.
It was Ryan!
Simon, calm down.
No, I can prove it. Kate's driving license, give it to me.
Yes!
Kate's driving license,
please. The final piece of the puzzle. The tape.
See that pattern on the tape there? Let me show you something.
Prime candidate tape.
See this pattern? Now look at that. It's the same pattern. This has come from the same roll of tape as this.
So?
So there's only one person has tape like that. Ryan.
In the whole world?
He gave me this piece of tape when I was in his office once. Why has Kate's driving license got a piece of Ryan's tape on it?
I have no idea, Sam.
Where did you find it?
Oh, by the lake.
That's obvious, isn't it? Ryan was testing her. He was doing a boundary test to see how much she would do, how far she would go to be a prime candidate. But it all went wrong. Okay. It's one of the things we do at the course, right? You give something that's important to you to someone else, then they go and hide it somewhere.
Like tape.
It's to teach you to not be bothered when you lose something that's important to you, all right? Kate gives her driving license to Ryan. Ryan goes and hides it somewhere down the lake. Kate finds out. She goes down looking for it, probably drunk, and she falls in.
I'm afraid I find that a bit far-fetched, Simon.
It makes perfect sense if you know anything at all about how Atlas works.
But Simon, if you got the tape from Ryan, Kate could have got it from him.
He told me he doesn't lend it out.
He lent it to you.
But I didn't kill her! Do a lab test on the card! His DNA will be all over it.
And what if yours is all over it?
It won't be! I didn't kill her! I'm sorry.
Was
just
he licking the card?
Just give me a minute. I need some painkillers.
You take painkillers? Is everyone on painkillers?
He made a solemn oath when he donned that thumb ring that he would never harm another being.
In the fucking bathroom. Also, did you just run away?
Tiptoe through the tulip thing.
Did you just run away?
Get some of that turkey chili, man. Pork curry. Chili pork.
Where did he go in such a hurry? Is he trying to act as suspiciously as possible?
It takes a lot to rouse your suspicion, Jinxie.
Yeah. Back to the site of the crime. Nope. To Atlas for the final confrontation?
Nope.
No. Wait. So, I should have... Ah, this
Ow.
Bullshit! Where did he go, Jenks? We fucking...
What? Go walk?
I've went to every...
Walk in the other direction from his house.
But it placed us in this direction from his house. So that's pretty stupid. It wants us to go the other way. Maybe he went to the city hall. Maybe he went to Rebecca's pub.
I would go straight down the line.
Well, he did say he was getting some painkillers.
That's true.
Everybody should just visit Paul Ryan, like
just
one
gonna
or the other.
Just gonna go gnaw on some poppy pods.
Poppy pods. What do you know about
this?
Just
a few more questions, if you don't mind. Ever seen tape like this anywhere before?
Nah.
Yeah.
I'm useless.
Do you know how well Simon knew Kate?
Not really.
Did you ever see them together?
So why? Do you think he killed her?
I've no idea.
Do you
think he'd be capable of that?
Don't you think we're all capable of it?
No, I don't.
Sure? So you've never been in your police car responding to an incident? Driven past school at high speed.
Don't know. Maybe.
Well, you've answered your own question then. When you've got a need and things get in your way, it's human nature to either ignore them or get rid of them. Any way you can. That's all murder is, isn't it?
Maybe you're right.
That was really... That was pretty convoluted, dude.
Thank you! Probably be back later.
I'm not sure if you made your point, but I guess...
I guess I'll leave. Goodbye.
Yeah, I'm just stunned into silence. I'm like, well, I have no way to contest that. His logic is locked tight. Anything behind the Brandon house? Nope. Maybe the... I mean, it looks like our only choices for interviews at the moment are Emma and Rebecca. Was Rebecca the one in the mask, or was it Emma? Which brunette?
Ask about a few more things, please. Have you seen patterned tape like this anywhere before?
Oh, Ryan's got some. I know, because I borrowed it.
God, he lends it to everybody! Even his
own wife.
Have
you still got it?
I don't think so. I haven't seen it since then.
Thank you. Probably be back
later.
Thank
you. Maybe go talk to Emma? Be like, where the fuck is your...
Well, yeah, I think she's our only other option.
What are you doing in here?
Just checking.
You're entering the outbuilding?
Maybe that's where Simon went to get the painkillers. Look, you never know when a wild cutscene is going to approach.
Wild cutscene emerges from the tall grass. Where are you going? Where are you going?
Just wondering how she fixed the broken mirror. Gotta have tape to fix broken mirror.
Wait, what?
A couple more questions,
masking,
if that's okay.
Or broken window. Masking.
Have you seen this anywhere
it
before?
It has scotch tape to fix the broken mirror.
I've seen it somewhere, but I can't remember.
It's on the license I showed
Sorry.
You at the beginning
no.
of the game.
Yeah.
That wasn't very helpful.
Did Simon mention walking home with anyone after the meeting last Friday?
No, he just came home. Why?
He didn't mention walking home with Kate.
No, definitely not.
That's it.
So you're useless, Emma.
That's all for the moment. Thank you.
I think it's the tape. It's her and the tape. It's the only clue we got.
Wait, her and the tape?
No, Rebecca and the tape. It's gotta be something about the window, but I don't know where the window is.
The argument one.
No, like... Have we ever been able to see
no,
the window?
No.
Well,
a broken window on an actual pub, I think, is out of their budget.
I guess you have a point.
Please?
Lost the tape. Like, there just has
to... Go to the argument one. Maybe use tape to do the window is in there.
I mean, there's
tape
that.
Tape to the window.
Well, that's
that's
stupid because
we last saw that
this is the only roll of tape that exists in this hamlet. Yes.
So how come you used it last week to tape over the broken window outside? That's the same tape.
Well, I must have been mistaken.
You see, the reason I'm asking is that it's exactly the same tape that was found attached to Kate's driving license, found at the scene. The tape that only Ryan has. Ryan... And, of course, you.
So what are you saying?
Who's got the tape now? Do you know where it is?
Who has
no.
the sticky tape now?
No, I don't
now.
Know where it is. Why are you asking me about this tape?
You seem nervous, Rebecca. Is there a problem?
Well, you practically accusing me of having something to do with that woman's murder, aren't you?
I wasn't accusing you of anything, Rebecca. Unless there's something you'd like to tell
me. All right, Jinxie, you're laying down.
No, I wouldn't like to tell you anything.
Yeah. Okay, well, that's fine. He's just obviously, we'll be swabbing everyone in the area for DNA, so if anything comes up on Kate's license, DNA traces.
What'll come up? Nothing will come up. Right, I've had enough. I've got to get back.
Rebecca! Would you like to explain to me exactly what is going on?
Which bit? The fact that some leggy bitch was trying to steal my husband?
I think you had better tell me what you know, Rebecca.
Okay. You want to know what I know? Kate Vine seduced my husband and was going to blackmail him. Not only did she sleep with him, that whore did it just for his money, our money.
How did you work that out?
I heard her. I knew it was her arguing with Emma Bowman. Emma was trying to talk her out of it.
And how did she come to be at the lake?
She dropped that driving license thing when she came in. She was drunk, she dropped her bag. I took it out to the woods and stuck it over the lake. Then I waited for her. When she came out, I told her where it was, said someone had just run off into the woods with it.
You led her to the lake.
She was reaching out over the lake to get it. I didn't do anything, she just fell in.
But you let her drown.
It was dark, I couldn't see anything, I couldn't help her.
Really? Did you try, Rebecca?
Well, it was too
late. Did you
Allison
her?
She was just flapping about in the water. It was pathetic, she was making these gurgling sounds.
And what did you do?
I got a big stick. I just pushed her down with it until she stopped.
Oh, okay.
Well, she was dead anyway. What did it matter?
She was dead anyway, and she was being annoying.
She slept with my husband.
She didn't, Rebecca.
What do you mean?
You got the wrong girl.
Who? Emma.
Now you're going to have to sit there your whole life. Emma. In jail.
Rebecca Rand, I am arresting you for the murder of Kate Vine. You do not have to say anything, but anything you do say may be taken down and will be used in evidence against you.
Probably should have said that before she confessed. Or I guess not. You probably should not have confessed.
Yes.
That was a really...
Why would you do that?
He was giving you a super soft sell.
It appears that Kate Vine's death... It's a tragic case of mistaken identity. But there are some loose threads here. What was Ryan doing with Kyle and that girl in the woods?
Contradiction 2.
And interrupted. And what really happened to Liam last year? It seems I've only scratched the surface of Atlas and the Rand business empire. Trying to find out about Paul Rand's past is like peering into dense fog. He gives nothing away and covers his tracks with military efficiency. However, what is known is that Paul Rand has a lot of connections in high places. Politicians, celebrities, business leaders. Perhaps James Wilson's ideas weren't too wide of the mark after all. I get the feeling there's still a lot more to learn about the Rand business empire.
Sweet.
You're gonna have to excuse us. Atlas is closed for the moment, but we'll be open again very soon.
Yes!
Thank you for your interest.
Who are you talking to? The cameraman? Okay. So.
Did we get the bad ending?
I love this game.
Did we get
I had so much fun playing
did
it.
Did we get the bad ending?
That ending was a piece of shit.
Yeah, that was really bad.
That was garbage.
Yeah, that was really
that
bad.
Fucking last contradiction was trash.
But
and the way
we,
it ended was
not,
bullshit.
Are we not, maybe we got the bad ending.
Oh yeah,
maybe. Maybe he
bad
that end. He took care of it by forcing somehow hypnotizing his wife into confessing to a crime she didn't commit.
Yvonne West got the end credit. Spectacular performance as Kate Vaughn.
It's pretty good, guys. It's a
yeah.
pretty good game.
The ending was completely irrelevant to every other piece of evidence of the game. We could have found that tape in the first 5 minutes.
Nope, that's the only ending. That is auto-hypnosis or... maybe just regular hypnosis.
That being said, apparently this is a Kickstarter game.
Oh, really?
Well, it says Kickstarter executive backers.
yeah.
I would kickstart another one of these.
Yeah, that was awesome.
But holy crap. Like, it was all flavor text, essentially. We could have... We held that fucking license with that fucking tape. It was probably the second thing we asked about in the entire game.
Like, we presumably saw the tape on the wall. Because Simon is the first suspect.
Wait, what's this?
That was high fives.
Oh, that was just some sort of, like, stinger thing.
All right, well, that was great. More games like that, please. Except for better endings.
Yeah, except it's like, writers wrote all these plot lines and went, how do we tie this all up? And the answer was, let's
just not.
Like, holy shit. I was like, man, we are just getting into the meat of this game.
Yeah.
And then it was like, no, it was the tape.
It was all the tape. That said, I think that it did a lot of things very well.
Yeah. Nick said Paul Darrow is still alive, by the way, even though it's as dedicated to. Your supportive is vital if we are to raise funding for a sequel. Well, I gotta assume
Let's go tell him to make a sequel.
Well, the thing is, like...
And please reuse all the actors.
Giant Bomb... No, that's what I was gonna say earlier today.
Except you can leave... Well, they should leave Legolas and Emma out.
This should... Yeah. Legolas and Arya Stark.
Yeah.
All grown up. No, this game...
Yeah.
It should be like American Horror Story.
Did I say that out loud?
No, I was thinking that earlier today. I was thinking
the same thing last time we played it. I was like, they should just do rotating, like, stories with the same actors.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a sequel.
Yeah.
Like, who cares about Liam? Sorry. Yeah.
Totally.
Wait, is there more?
What? Did you just...
It's free roam?
Yeah, I guess so.
Or is this just, wait, but we can't go back into the pub.
I was thinking that exact same thing, but I was like, they should do American Horror Story style. I couldn't remember if I said it out loud.
Wait, can we just walk around, but we can't go into any of the points of interest? Maybe we can visit James.
We could just go drink ourselves silly by the pond.
No, we haven't unlocked
that potential. Guys, that is not a lake. That is a pond. That is a pond.
From there, it looks like a lake.
That is a pond-ass pond. As somebody who lived near a pond, that is definitely a pond.
Go call boss to report. I cracked the case, boss. It's after midnight. We ruled it a suicide. Statute of limitations is extremely strict in England.
Dark age of the law.
The dark, yeah. You only got 3 days, Jenks. And you frittered it all the way on this Atlas bullshit when you should just ask about the tape that was on the license from the beginning of the game.
All right.
I bet somebody, some fucking writer in this game was like, it's the first thing you see. I'm a genius.
Are we gonna watch the fucking thing tonight?
Yeah, what time is it?
Because if so,
10:40.
Let's get started.
All right, we're out.
We gotta.
I mean, that was awesome, except for the ending.
That was awesome.
Otherwise, this game was great.
Yeah.
But that ending was shit.
Yeah.
Also, it was so bad.
Maybe work on your intro panel, like. Panel card. What do you call it? Intro card.
Screen. Yeah, title card. No, title it's Contra.
Oh, it's a reference?
No. I mean, but Contra is a game, and the way, you mean the way it like pans in?
No, I'm talking about literally.
Oh, you just mean
font
like
choice,
the start menu.
Their logo.
Like, well, they did. They put out that pad that changed the interface, and it was worse.
Yeah. No, not.
Bye, guys.
Later, everyone.
Thanks for watching and helping during that extremely rough patch.
Thanks for sticking
Thanks for that asshole that spoiled in the first night. I knew it was Rebecca the whole time. He just typed Rebecca did it 3 times before Nick was able to ban him.
What the fuck? Like, why?
Because some people are like 5 and I don't know, have nothing better to do. It would be awesome if he was literally a 5-year-old. It's
well,
like,
then he was just trying to help.
Yeah, it's like a throwback.
Guys, I'm just trying to help. I'm doing my best to help.
On the keyboard to help you solve the murder. All right.